Hi guys, welcome to this powerful video with Apostle Michael Robo. This particular video was carefully selected and edited to improve your knowledge on spiritual things and draw you closer to God. Don't forget to like this video, share with loved ones and family, and subscribe. Stay tuned.
You're coming to the ecosystem of God. You now know what is in the heart of God, and you begin to help God prosecute it. Because men are stiff-necked. So the limitations of men, you take it upon yourself and you intercede on their behalf for God. So sonship is the ability to walk the corridor of priesthood. And when a man begins to walk on the corridor of priesthood, there are four things he will find in legislation. Number one is that he will discover that in priesthood there are corpses.
Welcome to Believer's Mandate. Please like our videos, share and subscribe. Thank you and God bless you.
But there are two things you must do as a son. Those ones are beyond the calling. They are who you are. The first is priesthood. Priesthood in its most basic sense is the ability to stand in the gap between God and man. It's a man that insists that the purposes of God and the will of God must find expression. Everybody who truly becomes a son carries the burden of the Father. And one of the ways he prosecutes the burdens of God is to stand in the gap. When you study the life of Moses, you're going to see the most graphic expression of priesthood. Is angry, I will destroy these stiff-necked people. He said, far be it from you, Lord. Do you want the nations of the earth to hear that you deliver them from the hands of captivity to destroy them in the wilderness? Repent of this, Lord. That's a man talking to God. It's called priesthood. You're coming to the ecosystem of God. You now know what is in the heart of God, and you begin to help God prosecute it. Because men are stiff-necked. So the limitations of men, you take it upon yourself and you intercede on their behalf for God. So sonship is the ability to walk the corridor of priesthood. And when a man begins to walk on the corridor of priesthood, there are four things he will find in legislation. Number one is that he will discover that in priesthood there are corpses. Corpses. Priesthood is not just praying in tongues. There's a generation of people praying, but they don't know the courtesy of the spirit realm. When you come into priesthood, the first thing you will be taught are the courtesies of the presence. It's not everything you do in the presence of God. God is a king. There are many things that his presence does not tolerate. If you know the presence of God, you discover that the presence of God is the government of God. And for you to be able to bring change to your territory, you must master how to walk in God's presence. Because if God's presence does not come with you, your walls are empty. And so priesthood will teach you the courtesy of the presence. Every spirit has a courtesy that governs the operation of their presence. The reason is because spirits are not men. When we leave this room, we are going to leave the environment and go to another environment. Spirits are not like that. Spirits travel with their environment. Their environment is a part of them. And because their environment is a part of them, they don't tolerate compromise in their environment. Because if you denature their environment, you denature their being. You can mess up in this room, we'll leave you in this room and go to another place. We leave this environment behind. It doesn't work like that with a spirit. A spirit carries its environment. That's why when God comes to a place, his presence comes there. And so when you want to do priesthood, it's something you must do in God's presence. So there are courtesies you must obey. The first courtesy of priesthood is the courtesy of reverence. Every son understands the honor of the father. When Moses came to maturity and God wanted him to deliver Israel, and priesthood was about to begin, the first lesson God taught him was the lesson of reverence. He said Moses kept his father's sheep in Exodus chapter 3 verse 1 until he came to Horeb, the mountain of God, and he saw a bush burning that was not consumed, and he said, I will turn aside to see this great sight. And the moment he turned, God called him from the burning bush and said, Moses, take off thy sandals. He said, where you are standing is holy ground. If you don't understand the courtesy of honor and reverence for God, you can never be a priest. And if you are not a priest, then you have not grown into sonship. Because when you become a son, you must be a priest. Priesthood is God's plan from day one. He wanted to raise a nation of priests where everybody knows his heartbeat and live out his body. But the only way we can do that is when a nation becomes reverent to God. We have a generation where people are worshiping God and they are chewing bubble gum. We have a generation where people come into God's presence and they come haphazardly as if they are talking to their friends. They even show more reverence to their lecturers or their ethnic authorities much more than God. And they are hoping that God will come to deliver their land. They don't know the God they are talking to. When you know him, you will discover that in his presence, men tremble. Everyone that ever came into his presence fell on his face to the ground. When Isaiah saw him, he went down. When Ezekiel saw him, he went down. When John saw him, he went down. When Daniel saw him, he went down. Nobody stands there. Even the 20 and 4 elders, the Bible said, when the presence of God appears, they cast their crown. They fall from their throne and they sing, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Our generation is a baby's generation because what we do around God's presence is a testimony that we are not yet mature. And so we can't carry out priesthood legislation. When courtesy is not taught to a generation, that generation will never see the power and the glory of God. Take off thy shoes. Where you are standing is holy ground. The first courtesy of the presence is the courtesy of reverence. When was the last time you knelt down in God's presence? When was the last time you sensed that the presence of God was in the place and you went on your face? When was the last time God spoke to you and you trembled? God spoke to you and you were terrified. God has become your mate. He has become your friend. That is why he can't deliver your family. Because your friend don't have the power to deliver your family. God has become your mate. That's why he doesn't have the power to deliver your nation. Because your mate, 1,000 of them, can't deliver Kenya. The only one who can deliver Kenya is the one that is so big that you dread. Because you have discerned his size. If we don't have courtesy in God's presence, our priesthood cannot change anything in the territory. When God truly wants to help a people, he exposes them to reverence and honor. The second thing about courtesy in priesthood is the courtesy of silence. You know, when you are a child, you think the more you talk, the more you make sense. When God shows up, you discover the more silent you are, the more powerful you become. Because you are not as powerful as you speak. You are as powerful as you are commanded. Because it's what it tells you that makes the change. So after you have prayed in tongues, you have to wait in case he has something to say. Because when he talks, it becomes a verdict. And so we have a generation of people who pray in tongues long, but they don't come with verdicts because they are never quiet in God's presence. Did you read about Jesus when he took Peter, John, and James to the mountain? And when Moses and Elijah were talking to him, suddenly Peter interrupted and said, Master, it's good for us to build a tent here. Build a tent where? Do you know what is happening there? The prophet and the law is submitting to the kingdom. You want to go back to the era of the law and the prophet? Who told you they are building tent? They are migrating. You are talking about tent. So people do priesthood, they say what they don't know. And that's why they go nowhere. When priests begin to arise, one thing we learn is that we learn the art of silence. Because the more quiet you become, the more the king can speak. Because he talks only to those who listen and obey. So when you begin to grow in priesthood, one of the courtesy you learn is not just speaking in tongues. See, today people are speaking in tongues. They carry their phone and check WhatsApp. Keto, keto, kakato, pupakwa, keato, kato. They are speaking in tongues. They go on Facebook and check some of their views. They are speaking in tongues. They go on the live view. Even in church, while service is going on, you see, they are holding their phone. The view have grown from 200 to 350. They are in the, they are in the, they, their prayer can't touch the ceiling. Do you know where you are summoned to? Do you know the creatures that come there? He said, you have come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God. Do you know what it means when they call him the living God? It means in his realm, men don't die. So what he's trying to tell you is that Moses is still there. Elijah is still there. John the Baptist is still there. Paul is still there. You came to an endless lineage of patriarchs. Who told you you can talk there? Do you know the men who have traveled before you that are there, who are quiet, waiting for the king to talk? And then you show up with the garbage of earth. You carry earth and its corruption. You bring it there. You think it's about who can speak in capital letter tongue. Who told you they hear capital letter tongues there? With distraction and garbage, flesh, and we desecrate the altar because we don't understand the courtesy of the presence. And that's why our priesthood can go nowhere. When sons emerge, they know the dignity of honor. And when they come before the Lord, they know how to prostrate before him. When such men begin to rise in Kenya, 5 of them is enough to shut this nation down. Because it doesn't need a crowd to change a nation. It showed us the principle from day one. He wanted to deliver Israel from Egypt. He sent Moses. One man is enough. One man. We are more than 1,000, but we can't make any impact because we don't know where the true powers dwell. Thank God for our gifts. Thank God for the manifestation of the Spirit. Those ones are there to address needs. The things that change a generation and a territory, they are matters of government and governance that come from the realm of God. And it will take a man who understands the courtesy of that realm to bring that government to earth. I told you, the things we want to consider are maturity issues. They are not just emotional things. And God will allow you to grow through it, to go through it and to learn it. Sometimes it begins with your immediate family. And then it graduates you to an institution that you are part of. Maybe a school. And then it graduates you to the territory. And then it's showing you. Did you read about Moses? When he was on the mountain for 40 days, what did the Bible say Moses said? He said nothing. Only God was talking. Moses was only writing. He sat at the mountain for 40 days. He was quiet. You will never hear Moses said this. Said what? God was speaking, he was writing. But when he came with those tablets became the foundation of human civilization. Till today, all the laws of the earth realm are from the laws of Moses. Are you learning something? Have you been to that place where you are praying in the spirit and you go high, and then suddenly the Holy Ghost shut your voice? Ah, you are talking. No, keep quiet, keep quiet. The angels here, they are judgmental angels. Keep quiet. You can say something wrong. Have you been in a place of prayer? You say something, you know you have heard. They say, keep quiet. Keep quiet. Elders are talking. Thrones are talking. The monarch himself is talking. Your job is to carry it and go and announce on earth. Don't talk here. It's priesthood. When sons rise, we master this thing. That's why when you see those who become truly mature, they become very quiet and calm. You can sense that calmness, not because they are acting like this. It becomes a disposition of their spirit. Their spirit is silenced. they don't talk much again. Because everything they say is the decree of God. So their words are few. Because at that level, even if God doesn't talk and you talk, it's a law. And so at that level, you don't even crack jokes. You can tell somebody you are crazy and he goes crazy. Because you are talking from an energy. An energy. Anything you say is a law. So God will teach you silence before he brings you into power. We talk too much. We say what God is not saying. We claim God is saying it and nothing happens at the end of the day. Elohim. I have 10 minutes. I want to teach you some mysteries so that we can apply it here. But I don't have time again. In priesthood legislation, the first thing you learn is what? Courtesy. And I've mentioned two. There are many, but find the other ones. Bible study is not to cram scriptures, it's to search truth. The second courtesy in priesthood legislation is rank. You don't change things because you talk. You change things because of the rank where you are talking from. Men are graded in ranking. That's why a man will say what another person said. Their results are different. Have you seen five people gather before praying around one mad person? And they are quoting all the scriptures they know, and the scriptures are right. But the madman remains mad because they can't bring government to that ecosystem. And another man shows up and he looks at the man and says, leave him. You will now think, okay, it's those holding him he's talking to. When you people leave him, you discover that it's not only you that left him, even the demons left. Because when he said, leave him, he's talking to both you and the demons. It's rank. It's not about scripture. Our generation, we come, we quote this one, we quote this one. We don't know that there is rank in priesthood. And there are things that make for spiritual ranking. Number one is transformation. The first thing that gives you rank in the spirit is the degree to which you take upon yourself the nature of God. And so in this kingdom, a man who is broken has more rank than the man who has revelation. Revelation can be mental. Brokenness is of the spirit. So brokenness in the spirit realm is louder than revelation. That's why you see this generation, a young preacher will stand up. He will be giving revelation. Nobody can sit down. When he finishes giving the revelation, he will pray for the sick. Few people will come out and say, I have pain on my back. It's gone. Another man will come and just say, God told me to do this, to do this, to do this, and I did it. You now say, no, Father, you that led me in the dark, show yourself now. In the name of Jesus, be healed. In your eyes like this, you'll see two people stand up. He didn't quote any scripture. He came with rank. He came with rank because brokenness is a statement in that realm. So when a man wants to grow in rank in priesthood, the first thing that he must do is that he must submit himself to laws. Priests are beings that live by laws. They are broken beings. So when they come before God, their brokenness is a testimony in the spirit. That's why David said in Psalm 51 from verse 17, he said, a contrite heart and a broken spirit, thou shalt not despise. So when a broken man is talking, he can move heaven. You want to grow your priesthood, is beyond revelation. It's beyond how many hours you can speak in tongues. When you are speaking in tongues and making decrees, they will find out who is talking. They will check you out and find out how much of God do you carry. Do you look like God? Because the things you are speaking of, when God releases it, if you are not careful, it will make you godless. So one thing that confers authority in priesthood is the ability to carry more of the nature of God. So priests are beings of government. They are under the government of God until they keep growing and imbibing the nature of God. A priest is not just a man that makes declaration. It's a man that is first of all broken. It's a man that carries the nature of God. And his greatest weapon in the realm of God is his alignment. You don't have alignment, you will preach, you will pray. Sometimes when we even pray, the way we pray, the phrases we use, the English and the grammar, is too much for the demons to even hear what we are saying. So when we finish, just to tell the demon go, when we finish talking, the demon will say, excuse me sir, what do you mean? I'm willing to obey, but sir, what are, because of there is so much pride, we want to oppress those hearing us first. Let them know first that person talking there is learned. And when we are doing those things, our arrogance, our pride is rising up as an offensive odor in where power dwells. And so we finish everything, nothing happened. Because nature is the first rank of a priest. When you show up in that realm, they will find out, what nature do you carry? How much of the Christ do you manifest? How much of it do you look like? Because you may come in the nature of a serpent, and you are making decree for God's government. They know you are lying. It's your pride and ego you are trying to nurture. And so they can't release authority. The second rank of a priest, or what makes for rank in the realm of the priest, is your discernment of courts and court sessions. Priesthood is a legalistic exercise. If you don't understand the protocol of the courts of God, you can't bring legislation. There are certain times you are praying, the court you appear in, they are dealing with family issues. They are dealing with divorce. If you, they will kick you out. Wrong. Because that court session was set up to deal with issues of divorce and family crisis. So when you come into a court session, you need discernment before you start talking. That's why God will first of all teach you silence. You don't just show up and because you sense an atmosphere, you start talking things. No. You need to discern, which court have I appeared before? Is this a court dealing with nations? Before you can bring the issue of Kenya, there is a court you will enter. They are not talking about Kenya. They are talking about North America. It's a continental court. If you talk about a nation there, you are wrong. Because the legislation at that level has to do with continents. And so if you don't know what to do, you won't have the skill for negotiation. So in priesthood, one thing that will happen to you as you grow in rank is that you will learn ascension and you will learn discernment. Ascension is what will take you to court session, and discernment is what will teach you what. So when you are praying in tongues and you are still on earth, you are not a priest. That's why I told you, priesthood is beyond praying in tongues. Paul said, I knew a man many years ago. He was carried to the third heavens. He went to the galactic courts of God. At that level, Paul could see what was happening in heaven, on earth, and in Hades. That was why Paul said, I heard words that were unlawful to be uttered among them. Because what Paul was listening to was not just a legislation about men. He had gone past the realm of earth. They were judging demons in that realm. They were judging angels in that realm. So it would be an error for you to talk about men at that level. Because that court is not just dealing with men. He's dealing with angels and demons. And Paul said the things I heard. He said it's unlawful to be uttered among men. John was carried to heaven. He said, I heard the voice of the seven thunders. I wanted to write it. They said, no, don't write it. This one is not for the churches. The one that is meant for the churches we have written. This one is for those who can come here. This place is an assembly. The reason is because, can I talk about this? I'm on I wish it was a closed session. John was about to translate. Because listen, ministry does not end on earth. Earth is the training ground for ministry. True ministry begins when earth ends and men translate. Those who are prophets, hear this. Those who are prophets are not just called to give word of knowledge. A prophet is God's symbol and symbolism to a territory on the strength of righteousness. The manifestation of the prophetic office is to bring the righteous government of God to a people. And so when a man passes it as a genuine prophet, he is engrafted into the company of elders in the kingdom. Prophets are actually elders in the world to come, because issues of government and righteousness is allocated to prophets. Can I tell you about apostles? Apostles in the world to come are messengers. When the new world is created, some apostles will become angels to those worlds. And so what was happening to John was that John was about to be translated, not just to become an earthly apostle, but to become a celestial apostle. That was why when he finished in Revelation 19, he saw somebody wanted to worship him. He thought that was an angel. He said, I'm not Jesus. I'm one of your brethren. The guy had graduated. So John was no longer an apostle. John had become a celestial messenger. In the world to come, he will be a messenger to that world. That was what was happening to John. He was being shifted. So what the seven thunder told him was not a message to the churches. It was a message to his spirit. Ministry does not end on earth. That's why when God calls you to priesthood, he's inviting you to something bigger than you. Did you not read about Moses? Jesus was about to die for man. And then Moses and Elijah came. And the Bible said they were telling him what he should do. How can men be telling God what to do to save men? Because these men were prophets. They had grown into elders in the world. So God had brought them into legislation about the fate of humankind. If you call those ones men, you are wrong. Because they are no longer men. They are elders of heaven. So priesthood is beyond time. It's government and governance. And that governance transcends time. They came to tell Jesus what he must do. In the cloud of glory. Those are not prophets. They have grown from prophets to elders. And there are many who will grow from apostles to messengers. Because the word apostle is the word apostolos. It means a sent one. And you are not only sent to men. A time comes when you graduate, God begins to send you to dispensations. And then you can travel from one dispensation to another dispensation, and you will bring the word of the Lord to them. I wish I can tell you the origin of Gabriel. And then you understand the apostolic ministry. In his full regalia, he's a sent one. And God does not send you to only to one dispensation. A point will come, you will traverse many dispensations to God. Greater than John, because greatness is not about how many followers, Do you know that the followers of John left him and followed Jesus? He said, but of all men that lived. He said, from the time of John, that means in the dispensation of mortals, there is a whole generation wielded to John. That man doesn't have a congregation, but he owns that generation. So when you read the books of God, you will open a chapter when they call it the chapter of John. Everybody that existed in that generation will be part of John. John becomes the progenitor of that generation. That's what priesthood does. And so when men begin to ascend into courts in heaven, they are coming to take inheritances and legislations. So a man can appear in a court and they will tell him, we have given Kenya to you. He doesn't need the church to be a great man in Kenya. He can sit in his room at night, and if he wakes up and say, I approve the governor, I approve the president, you will see that in 3 days the president will go down. Because that one is the owner of Kenya. You may think Kenya is a republic. Every nation belongs to men in the spirit. Oh, you don't know. Who told you? It's among men that they call them republic. In the spirit, nations belong to men. In the spirit. I wish I can tell you who owns Nigeria. He's not even a Nigerian. His name is Baelti. I'm online. I can't say some things. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Let's talk here. If I say some things now to me, you know, there are too many babes. So when you talk spiritual things, instead of blessing them, they start fighting you. Because they don't ascend. They don't ascend. Come up here. There are some courts. See, you will come into some courts. And when you enter, you will hear they will be discussing the fate of Kenya. You will now sit down and listen. You will know why things are happening the way they are happening in Kenya. Because nothing happened on earth. Everything happening on earth is a product of judgments and legislation. And so when a priest wants to grow, he must ascend into courts. There are many courts in heaven. There are certain courts when men are judged. Say to Zacharias, the garment is wearing his filthy. That's a high priest. For him to have relevance here, he said, take off that filthy garment. Meanwhile, somebody else who is not in the political office of priesthood is the one pleading on behalf of Zacharias. When they come to earth, Zacharias will say, I'm the high priest. He doesn't know in the spirit. The reason he's still there is because somebody has ascended to that court who has authority to talk where he can't talk. He's talking. God is lacking priest. Men can ascend. You stay in your room, you distract yourself with movies for 7 hours. When your fellows are digging, when your fellows are traveling, you distract yourself with YouTube. You are watching movies. You're on Netflix. A priest spend 4 hours on Netflix. Meanwhile, the fate of Kenya is being decided. You don't even know the day. I can tell you, there are some men who will tell you, next Tuesday, they will discuss Kenya. And they know because they've been to heaven. They know the calendar. They can tell you the day they will pass the judgment over Kenya. And in the spirit, that day they will come there and tell God, how about the covenant you made to the fathers? Show mercy. And so the reason Kenya will stand is because of those men that have no names. And then you are wasting your time with Netflix. To pray now. If I go beyond here now, I will say some things. They may call it heresy, so I will stop. Because even those in Nigeria are watching. Tomorrow you will hear, they will say, Apostle Mike said, the owner of Nigeria is power healthy. Then people will start fighting because very few people go there. Very few people. Do you know who owns Kenya? Do you know? If you know who owns Kenya, you will go back and study his walk with God. And you will find out, what did God tell him? You will find out, what were the dealings of the spirit that God subjected him to? Because the only way you can reclaim Kenya is to find out the life of that man. Because his life will become a roadmap for the nation of Kenya. That's why today they study Moses. Because he bettered Israel. You know, you must understand there's a God that you will find in the secret place to have authority in Israel. But we have not done it. He said in Songs of Solomon chapter 4 verse 4, he said the neck of David is a mountain. He said upon it are the armors of many warriors. There are some men that fought in Kenya and held government back. They've gone to be with the Lord, but nobody can wield their mantle. You didn't check in the spirit. You have not ascended. Those things are in courts. They are waiting for those who can come and say, Father, Kenya cannot go backward. We insist that we appear in what you spoke concerning this nation. And when they insist for a long time, God will hand over those mantles to them and send them back to Kenya. That is how priesthood changes territories. Maybe I should stop there and leave you with a body. Tomorrow we can do power. Some things are more than power. There are 8 things I put about ranking of priesthood. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Listen, don't pray religiously. I've said 2 things here. Number 1, I spoke about alignment. Some of us, our garments are filthy. That's why we can't bring deliverance to this nation. As you pray, you will ask God to purge that area. Nobody knows it. But the business you are doing is among spirits. It's not among men. Men can clap for a fornicator. They won't know. But in the spirit realm, they say you have come to an innumerable company of angels. To the spirit of just men made perfect. You have come where they see beyond what eyes, ordinary eyes see. And so that is a filth in that realm. It can't let you wield power. And then there are some of you that you can't ascend and you can't discern. So you pray, but you don't know what is happening above your head. If that is your case, what you'll be asking God tonight is, give me access. Give me access. Give me access. I want to journey to where the patriarchs journeyed and they shaped this nation. Give me access. Give me access. And if you have a filthy garment, you will tell the Lord, purge me with your blood. I want to do business in deep waters. I don't want to be shut out. I don't want to be told the stories of my country. I want to be part of those who will shape it. You want to pray those prayers? Ask the Lord in 2 minutes. Talk to the Lord now. It's a conference of songs. I wish I have clearance to say some things, but I've said too much already.
Thank you for watching this very video we brought your way. We believed you are mightily blessed. Contained in this message are steps and principles you could apply to your life and get the desired result that is required to take you into the next level of your spiritual journey and walk with God. Once again, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel, and most importantly, share this video with friends, family, and loved ones. We would love to hear from you. Share your thoughts down below in the comment section, and we'll see you in our next video.